meteors and meteorites are hitting the Earth every day. In fact, every day, something probably about 4 meters across hits the planet Earth. We just don't usually notice it because they burn up high up in the atmosphere. In fact, over the course of a whole year, something like 40,000 tons of material rains down on the Earth every year. We distinguish between asteroids and meteorites because a meteorite is what we call something that hits the Earth's atmosphere. Strictly speaking, it's a meteorite when it hits the ground, it's a meteor in the air, and before that, it's anything you want to call it, an asteroid or just a chunk of material in interplanetary space. We think that what we're seeing now in asteroids and meteorites striking the Earth is really the tail end of a very, very long process that began 4.5 billion years ago, really as soon as the Earth coalesced into a planetary mass. It's been hit by stuff. And that material raining down on the Earth brings in a huge amount of the chemistry and the raw elements that go into forming the outer parts of our planet. As far as we know, there is absolutely no relationship between the Siberian event and asteroid 2012 DA14. It seems like an incredible coincidence, but they were coming from very different trajectories, very different orbits. There seems to be no physical relationship between these two things. The real issue here is that there are lots of these things out there, but the smaller they are, the harder they are to spot. And so we've done very well at surveying for so-called near-Earth objects, asteroids that are in orbits around the Sun that occasionally might intersect with ours. And we think we know of about 10,000 such objects. Those range from the size of maybe a few tens of meters up to perhaps a kilometer or two. But the truth is, that's just the tip of the iceberg. We just can't see all of these things. They're small, they're dark, they're difficult to spot. So in fact, the great majority of objects that are smaller than about 100 meters, and each of those could be quite devastating if they hit a city, for example, we just don't know where they are. So we don't know exactly when the next one is going to hit us. If we identify an object, maybe a kilometer-sized asteroid, which is essentially a civilization killer, if we identify something like that ahead of time, there are actually a number of options available to us in terms of deflecting or destroying those bodies. We might be able to literally blow them up. That's always an option. But there may be cleverer things that we can do. We can actually go to them and we can slightly alter their orbit, either by attaching thrusters to them or even things as simple as painting them white. People have discussed how if you change the reflectivity of asteroids, the Sun's own radiation will actually blow against them differently, and conceivably over many, many years can alter their orbits in such a way that they will no longer hit us. As an astronomer and astrobiologist, one of the things that excites me the most about this sort of event is not the destruction and the human hardship, but the fact that this is part of a natural phenomena that has been going on forever, has played a vital role in assembling our planet into what it is. And of course, now we're beginning to find planets around other stars where the situation is going to be some variation on what we experience. So we'd like to know, for example, if we find other Earth-type planets, are they too being hit by meteors and asteroids and comets and so on? And what's that doing to the environment on those planets? So it's a very interesting jigsaw puzzle. So anytime something like this happens, I think it really brings it to people's attention that we live in a dynamic universe. Stuff happens all the time. It just doesn't always happen on human timescales. And it's very important to be reminded of that.